You're rocking your creative business, meeting with leads, traveling to events, and pumping out amazing things for your clients. Somewhere along the way, even a creative entrepreneur needs a meal or two. Did you know some of those meals may be tax deductible? I'm about to give you all the details on when and how to deduct meals as a creative entrepreneur. Let's start from the beginning. Before 2018, there was a tax deduction called meals and entertainment. Unfortunately, the new tax laws for 2018 removed the entertainment part of that deduction altogether. You can read more about that in my post, Bye-Bye Entertainment Deduction, linked below this video. But the good news is you can still deduct the meals portion of that deduction. But let me break it down for you so you understand what you can deduct and when. First things first, the 50% rule. You can only deduct 50% of all allowable business meals on your tax return. However, for bookkeeping purposes, you can totally include 100% of those meals on your books. You should pay for all allowable business meals with your business account to make sure that everything for your business is running through the business account. The 50% will be calculated on your tax return. The IRS defines meals as food, beverages, related taxes, and related tips. What's an allowable business meal, you ask? The IRS says if a meal meets the following criteria, it's an allowable business meal. It has to be ordinary and necessary to your business, not lavish or extravagant. Unfortunately, like many things, this is a gray area. The IRS doesn't actually have a definition for lavish or extravagant. So make sure the meal you're deducting meets all the other criteria in this list and is reasonable. You or an employee of yours must be present at the meal. I can hear you now, but what if it's one of my contractors? And this is very common in the creative entrepreneur space, so I'll dive into that a little deeper in the next section. The meal needs to be with a business contact, for example, a contractor, an employee, or a client. If the meal is part of an entertainment event and the cost of the meal is listed separately and the meal meets all other criteria, you can deduct it. For example, you take a client, contractor, or an employee, a business contact if you will, to a baseball game. If the ticket is purchased separately from the food and you discuss business at some point during the event, you can deduct the meals that you purchase, but only if they're listed separately. All of the above allowable business meals should be tracked in your business bookkeeping. Meals and contractors. This is a common scenario for creative entrepreneurs, so let's look at a few situations so that you can see when and how you can deduct the meal. If you're with the contractor at the meal, you can pay for the meal with the business funds and deduct it as long as it meets the five criteria of an allowable business meal we've already discussed. The expense belongs to you. If you're not with the contractor at the meal, technically, your contractor is self-employed, so in this scenario, if you're not there, they should incur this fee as a meal deduction for their own business. They will pay for it and keep track of it for their own taxes as long as it meets the five criteria of an allowable business meal. For example, your contractor is meeting with a client of yours for a coffee to discuss the project that you're all working on. Your contractor will pay for the meal and write it off on his or her own taxes. The expense belongs to the contractor. What about meals by myself? Many creatives will pop into a coffee shop to work remotely. While this may be hugely inspiring or a nice change of scenery, unfortunately, anything you consume while working alone at the coffee shop is not a deduction and should be paid for with personal funds. This situation does not meet two of the five criteria for an allowable business meal. Remember, an expense must meet all five criteria to be allowable. This situation doesn't meet criteria one. Working alone from a coffee shop might be necessary for your creative juices, but unfortunately, the IRS doesn't consider it necessary for your business. This situation also doesn't meet criteria four. You may be working on your business, but you're not in the company of a business contact. Meals alone will most likely never meet all five criteria unless you are traveling. So let's talk about travel meals. Travel is the only time you can deduct an allowable business meal when you're alone. The IRS says if your business trip is overnight or long enough that you need to stop for sleep or rest to properly perform your duties, you can deduct your meals that you consume on that trip even if you're alone. Now that you know when and how to deduct meals as a creative entrepreneur, remember, you can only deduct what you track. Be sure to keep receipts and details for all meals and include notes of who the meal was with and what the meeting was about. This way, you have everything you need if you're ever audited.
Hey, did you like this video? If so, give it a thumbs up and then subscribe to my channel for more videos like this one. If you want to learn the 5 bookkeeping basics every creative entrepreneur needs to know, then sign up for my free webinar by clicking on the link below this video or going to fashionaccounting.com/help-me. Until next time, I hope you create more and stress less.